Hello and a very warm welcome to the fifth round of the Maserati Trofeo season. Suzuka in Japan, the prestigious venue for this round. Roman Monti is trying to win the title here. His main rival, Riccardo Ragazzi, and the guest driver here is Shinji Nakano, the former Formula One star.
Immediately from the free practice. During the qualifying, I did a very good lap. I'm happy to be in front of a Japanese driver, a very fast driver, and I hope to finish in front of them at the end of this race. We will see, the race is long. My dream is finish on the podium, but anyway, we will see during the race.
I'm a little bit disappointed of the qualification. Even if I got the ballast, I think I could do a little bit more to be in second place, not in the fourth. But I think we have the pace to overtake the guys in front and maybe to fight with Ragazzi today. We will see during the race.
Riccardo Ragazzi then on pole position, earning that in the Super Pole. Roman Monti is down in fourth. Shinji Nakano second, Lino Curti third. Roman Monti is the only driver who can become champion here. Abu Dhabi is the final round, that's in mid-December, but Monti could be crowned champion here in Japan. We're on board with Carlo Curti, and if we're chosen to go on board with him, it's because he gets penalised for a jump start. Pretty difficult to see from these pictures. Curti trying to carve a way through, and he jumped the start. Carlo Curti started down in 13th. Let's have a look at Alessandro Iazzetti now, the number 27. He started in 11th, and he too will be penalised for a jump start. Second penalties then for both of these. So Riccardo Ragazzi leading, Shinji Nakano second, Roman Monti up to third now. Shinji Nakano, the Formula One driver, 1997 and 1998. He competed for Prost Grand Prix in 97 and for Minardi in 1998. No doubt we'll talk about Shinji Nakano a bit more in a bit. The local guest driver, he won't score points in the championship standings. Board with Curti now. Carlo Curti this. Lino Curti started third on the grid. Oh, Carlo Curti off. A big scare for Carlo Curti. The car in front of him messed up his line and Carlo Curti followed him. Still Ragazzi, Nakano and Monti, the top three. Lino Curti dropped to fourth, then Adrian De Lina. A car's gone off. I think it's Claudio Giudici. Indeed it is Giudici, who was running in the top 10. And of course the yellow flag comes out, it's a safety car. The restart then, and we're on board with Roman Monti, the championship favourite. Third in the race, Nakano just in front of him and still leading the race, the pole sitter, Riccardo Ragazzi. Ragazzi got the point for pole. He could get the 20 for the win. But no need for Monti to panic. Nakano will not score championship points. He's the guest driver. Monti would get 15 for being second and would only lose 6 points to Ragazzi on the first day of this meeting. Monti wants to take on Nakano here. He is a racer and it's normal, even when you're competing for the championship. And Monti has got into the slipstream now of Nakano. This is the chance for Shinji Nakano to be overtaken by Romain Monti, the Frenchman. And Monty's going to do it. Excellent overtaking move from Romain Monti. Monti has got some ballast on board after finishing second at the last meeting. And it'll be difficult for him to overtake Ragazzi. It was a great overtake, though, from Romain Monti on Shinji Nakano. Ragazzi is having a very good weekend, and his car is lighter than Monti's. See, Carlo Curti's in the top 10 despite the problems we saw for him earlier. Oh, trouble here. It's the number 7 of Giuseppe Fasicolo. He can get going again though, so we will not need the yellow flag for this one. Back to the front with Riccardo Ragazzi. A stroll in the park for him. Excellent race from Riccardo Ragazzi and the win for him. Romain Monti second, overtaking Shinji Nakano on that very last lap. A precious second place for him. Nakano third, then Adrian Delena. Ragazzi making up 6 points on Romain Monti then.
Bravo, Buello!
Very happy to won today here because I won in Shanghai, I won here, I won in Sonoma. All the race outside Europe was mine. I'm happy. See you tomorrow.
It's a good thing to be second at the end of this race, and now I think I'm close to the championship, to win the championship, so that's a really good thing for me. And congratulations to I think it's Nakano, because he was very fast today, and it was a great pleasure to race here with an ex Formula One driver.
Okay, champagne!
Still a second race to come. Round 5, race 2 from Suzuka and the inverted starting grid from the top 10 from race 1.
I'm driving this beautiful car, Maserati, here in Suzuka. Well, I was a little bit worrying about this first experience because I'm originally from a single-seater driver, so I have not much experience in GT car actually. So I was worrying if I can drive well or not. But yesterday I had 1 hour and 45 minutes of practice and felt quite good. The balance of the car is really good, very easy to adapt actually, and engine performance is very good. Drivability and brakes are really good. So actually really easy to drive.
Well, Nicolò, I'm looking
for a good start.
Oh, no, here's Richard Denny.
Some fast boys behind me, but if I can get a good start and get a clear run, I just want to have a nice clean race and go as quick as possible.
Well, Denny fifth on the starting grid. This is the end of the formation lap, and Monti ninth on the grid. Ragazzi 10th, Monti in the 31, Ragazzi in the 29. On board with Monti. Just needs a point to be champion. Oh, there's trouble here. I think it's Ragazzi who's gone straight off. Oh, drama, because he was the only man who could deprive Romain Monti of the title. This should be really straightforward now for Romain Monti. Let's have another look at the start then, and what happened to Ragazzi. Here he is, there's contact here. He tried to force his way through, straight off Riccardo Ragazzi. Incredible after his brilliant race one win. Ragazzi is out. On board with Adrian Delano. We should see this better now. Ragazzi just keeps on going. Well, Ragazzi out, and his title hopes up in smoke. Surely Monti will get the point that he needs. Monti just needs to finish in the top 10 now. Alessandro Fogliani is the race leader. He started second on the grid. Monti trying to clinch the title with one round to spare. Abu Dhabi, in mid-December. Now with Emanuele Smura. He started third on the grid. Smura a bit wide there. Oh, he's been hit. Smura has been hit. Can get going again though, despite losing a few positions there. I reckon 6-7 spots that Smura has gone down in the standings. Now, Adrian Delano. Let's see how it happened. Oh, there we go. He was clipped. Delano had to cut the corner. The swings and roundabouts of the Maserati Trofeo World Series. Delano got past Nakano and Monti by cutting the corner. But both of them have come past Adrian Delano again. Now, Romain Monti chasing down Shinji Nakano again, just like in race one. As things stand, Romain Monti is champion-elect because he's in the points. Nakano shutting the door on the Frenchman. Nakano very quickly up to speed here. Fogliani still leading. Here goes Monti, there's not much space there. Must be contact, and there was contact. The front right of Monti, the back left of Nakano, who's still holding him off. Monti is quicker, but he needs to find some space to get past. Oh, he's pushing Nakano now. Bigger contact. Nakano into the gravel there. Monty off. Monty can get back out onto the track. Ah, there was contact between Monty and Nakano. Will the race marshals decide to impose a penalty on Roman Monty there? Nakano onto the grass, or more contact. He was clipped again. Was Nakano? That was by Carlo Curti. Adrian Delaney on board with him, as we can see what happens with Monty and Nakano. Narrowly missing Delena. Safety car. And Raymond Monty caused that crash. He faces a nervous wait now. Shinji Nakano out of his car. His car will need to get taken away. Carlo Curti's as well. A real pity for Nakano. There was a puncture there for Nakano, and that surprised Roman Monty, and he ended up going into him. Manuel Ismura then for the restart, looking for a podium finish. But what just happened could be really important in terms of the title battle. Roman Monty will undoubtedly be penalised. He'll pick up a drive-through penalty. If that puts him outside the top 10, then that'll be huge. Fogliani wins. An amazing win for him. His first win in his debut year. Another rookie, Alexander West, finishing second. We're on board with Delena. Well, Monty going into the stands on the last lap. He had three laps to go in for the drive-through, but this is the finish. Crazy decision from Roman Monty. He could have gone right to the end, and they'd have just added 25 seconds to his time. Maybe Roman Monty doesn't know that this is the last corner, otherwise he wouldn't have come in. In he comes though to the pit lane, in for the drive-through, but it's too late. You can see what happens when he gets out to the end of the pit straight. It's shut, because the race is over. He's trapped. If he'd stayed out there and we'd added 25 seconds, he'd have finished 10th and he'd got the point he needed to become champion. But there are red lights, he can't come out. He'll end up being classed 11th, no points, and the title battle goes to Abu Dhabi. He's not officially champion. He should become champion, but this is an incredible end for Roman Monty. Drama at the end. He says he didn't know it was the last lap. So, confirming the standings, Fogliano, West, Delina, Denny, Smura, Iazzetti, Gradici, Fascicolo. But no Roman Monty, he hasn't got the point. No Nakano, his race finished early. Well done, Alessandro Fogliani.
My first victory in this Trofeo. It's my first year. I'm very happy to win this race. I'm pushing hard from the start. And also when there are the safety car at the restart, I'm pushing very hard. I defend my position and all is good. I'm very, very happy. This Trofeo is fantastic. It's incredible. Thank you very much.
Alexander West, another rookie, in second. West from Hong Kong.
I had a lot of defending from people behind, so it was hard to defend and trying to catch Alessandro, who did a really good race. He made no mistakes whatsoever, so I was waiting to see if he was going to make any mistakes, but he did really, really well, so it was a fantastic race. A lot of fun.
I love this track, fantastic, fast corners, I really like it a lot. Yesterday was a good result in third, today I thought I could do more, but starting from seventh with the safety car, I kind of ruined my strategy to push as fast as possible at the beginning, and at the end I was a little bit held up, and one thing is to catch up, the next is to pass, and passing at Suzuka is really tough.
So the championship battle goes to Abu Dhabi, Monty messing it up in race two at Suzuka. And we'll see you for the final round.